morning, Penn High School, and welcome PSAT survivors and sleepin' seniors. I'm your anchor, Kelly.
And I'm Marie. Today is October 14th, and it is a Friday. Let's get right into it.
For all juniors and seniors interested in joining National Honor Society, applications are now available. Check your email to start the NHS application process. Contact Mrs. Tagliaferri via email at ktagliaferri@phm.k12.in.us with any questions.
Attention all academic Super Bowl contestants. There will be an informational meeting on Thursday, October 13th from 3:30 to 4 o'clock in the IMC. Contact Coach Candace Bilart at cbilart@phm.k12.in.us for more information.
Now let's kick back, relax, and enjoy some entertainment updates with Brandon.
Hello, Penn High School. It's Brandon again with your entertainment rundown for the week. Smile is the new psychological horror that has been sweeping the box office. This is Parker Finn's directorial debut, with reviews coming in from both IMDb and Rotten Tomatoes, praising it for its well-crafted jump scares and original story. Rotten Tomatoes gives the film a 78% for both critic and audience reviews, with IMDb giving the film a 6.9 out of 10. Smile is in theaters now, starring Sosie Bacon, Jesse T. Usher, Caitlin Stacey, and Kyle Gallner. Smile 2022 is rated R, directed by Parker Finn, and distributed by Paramount Pictures. Werewolf by Night is the newest film to enter the Marvel roster, being Marvel's first TV film, clocking in with a runtime of 53 minutes. Reviews have been praising it as a breath of fresh air for the MCU, with the central plot being on the focus of Marvel's mythology, involving the history of monsters like vampires, werewolves, and other assorted creatures. Rotten Tomatoes gives the movie a 91% for critic reviews and a 92% for audience reviews. IMDb was a little less positive, giving the film a 7.4 out of 10. Werewolf by Night stars Gael Garcia Bernal and Laurel Donnelly. Only available on Disney Plus, rated TV-14, and directed by Michael Giacchino. Niles Screen Park has opened its doors yet again for the Halloween season. Located in Niles, Michigan, the 44-acre plot of land has become the setup for the number one attracted for the Top Haunts magazine in 2021. With many costume guests attending, like Michael Myers and Captain Jack Sparrow of the Pirates of the Caribbean movies. The attractions featured include the classic Niles Haunted House, Haunted Hayride, Field of Screams, and Hooded, with the guest attraction being the Sinister Streets of Salem and the Evil Estate. Niles Screen Park is open now until November 5th, 2022. Visit Niles Screen Park's official website, haunted.org, for more information. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Brandon, for the entertainment update.
Are you into cultures and would like to know more about them? Go check out the Penn Art Gallery across from the Ox Gym. The art gallery features a wide variety of works, including paintings and sculptures. It features student works and a select amount of professional works. The gallery is open Monday through Friday during school, 8:30 a.m. to 3:10 p.m.
This just in, according to Coach Harper, Penn sports are excelling at
domination.
Welcome back to sports. I'm your anchor, CJ, coming at you with the deets about this past week's sports events. Last Saturday, the boys and girls cross-country teams competed at sectionals in South Bend on Erskine Golf Course. In the boys' race, Nick Probst finished third with a time of 16 minutes and 27 seconds. Matthew Givens scored fourth place, right behind Nick, with a time of 16 minutes and 33 seconds. The girls' team did fantastic in their race as well, with Mary Eubank ranking first overall with a time of 19 minutes and 38 seconds. PNN reporter Nathan Tingle got an interview with the outstanding runner. So let's head to that now.
What kind of pressure were you having when you were running that race?
Not very much for that race. I will, the next 3 weeks, have a lot more pressure on me, but that race was just really fun.
And, you know, how does this team look for state, possibly?
Really good. I think this is the best team we've had since I've been here.
All right, and, you know, what did it take to take such a big lead in the final mile of that race?
I guess I was preparing for it. I was, like, thinking it through the night before, like, deciding, like, when exactly I was going to pick it up. And so I just went through with the plan.
All right, thank you, Mary, and that's all we have for you on PNN.
Thanks, Nate, and good job, Mary. The Penn girls soccer team has been on a roll this month. On Tuesday, October 4th, the Penn girls soccer team battled Michigan City, winning 9-0 in the first round of sectionals. On October 6th, they played St. Joseph and won 4-3. Then last Saturday, they tied South Bend Adams 1-1. At the time of this recording, they were slated to play Goshen High School, so we will give you those scores next week. Good job, girls, and good luck. The boys' soccer team has also been doing well and won against Goshen with a score of 5-4. Andre Gomez made a spectacular goal with an assist from Nicky Schnabel, making the score 1-1 in the sixth minute. The team will be heading to the regional championship this Saturday at 4 p.m. here at Penn. Make sure to get out and support our Kingsmen. The Penn boys tennis team ended last Saturday. They fell to number 1 West Lafayette Harrison 3-2 in the Culver Academy semi-state. Number 28 ranked Coach Eric Bowers finished 18-3. They also won the program's first regional title since 2018. Penn had to beat rival St. Joseph 3-2 and Chesterton 5-0 earlier in the week to claim the LaPorte regional crown. Good job and congratulations to the tennis team. PNN reporter Ethan Derby chatted with Penn volleyball player Kate Trueblood about the team's progress. Here is Ethan's report with a report on volleyball.
I feel like we've done pretty good. We've had some losses, but I feel like with every loss we've grown, and each loss helps us to just improve and shows what we need to continue to work on. I think our biggest struggle is just like after last year setting a new standard for this year and just pushing our hardest every day. I think our toughest loss this season was against Elkhart. I think it really helped us grow as a team. We kind of bonded after that and came together more, and it helped with our mental side of the game too. I think our biggest strength is just our community. Like, we definitely fall back on each other, and like they're all our like best friends, and we just love to be around each other.
How is the team preparing for the sectionals match this Saturday?
We're preparing by going into every practice with the mindset that we don't know yet who we're gonna play, and just that we just need to play our hardest and practice our hardest so that whoever we do play, we can win.
Thanks, Ethan. This past Friday, the Penn football team clinched a shareholder spot for the NIC conference, and with a win against Adams, they will win the title outright. The scores from their game against New Prairie were mainly from Nolan McCullough, rushing for 3 touchdowns, and the Wild Bunch pitching another shutout, having kept teams out of the end zone for 13 quarters with a score of 21-0. The Kingsmen take on Adams this Friday, the 14th. Good luck, boys. Great job, Kingsmen. Make sure to go out and watch some Kingsmen sports this weekend. Now, back to the desk.
Thanks, sports team. Congratulations to all of our squads, and best of luck as you start making your bids for state. Remember, go Penn.
Finally, the Penn High School Exceptional Ed Department provides a reliable coffee service to teachers out of room 181. The program is called Penn Mart, and it is run by Penn teachers, Crystal Wheeler. She and her students prepare coffee, fall-inspired treats, as well as handcrafted items such as candles, lanyards, and magnets for the staff and students to buy. All the money goes back to the program. Gabrielle Silibert got out into the field and interviewed Mrs. Wheeler about the program.
The goal of the project is to provide job opportunities for students, give them skills for after they graduate from high school.
That's all we have for you today, Penn High School.
Follow us on all of our socials at Penn News Network. Have a great weekend, Penn High School.
Excuse me, guys.
Lucid footage.
Got you one.
We're recording?
No, I think we're in the clear.
What's up, Vic?
You definitely did hear us.
Excuse me, man.
Why don't we do a quick interview?
You got a runner.
What's your Halloween costume gonna be?
Gru from Despicable Me.
That's good.
Priscilla Presley.
I'll be a vampire, I guess.
I'm gonna be Batman. Y'all better watch out.
Oh, I'm gonna be Kenny McCormick from South Park.
Katy Perry.
I'm gonna be the Cat in the Hat.
Oh, Incredibles. Oh, I'm one of the Incredibles.
Nice. A cow.
Nice, that's real nice.
Nope.
Oh, we don't do Halloween, but last year I really wanted to try it, so I cut a few pineapples and just gave it to them.
Beast Boy.
Oh, that's nice.
I'm gonna be a pirate with my cat that has one eye, and he's gonna wear an eye patch over his non-existent eye.
It's a little early. I don't know yet.
Never early. It's never early. But Halloween.
I'm gonna be McQueen and my girlfriend's doing Sally.
Nice. We always loved a couple outfits.
I plan on being a Penn Kingsman.
Oh yeah.